thing I neglected to mention, a lot of things I neglected to mention in Franco-Prussian War, is the von Clausewitz series. And the rules are interspersed with quotes from Clausewitz. And also, the game is designed to highlight Clausewitzian elements. Schwerpunkt, the national morale, because it's combat has to have a purpose. It's not simply the destruction of the enemy's forces, although that is vital. It's destroying his will and his ability to conduct combat, the supply rules, etc. All kind of work together for that. So it's kind of an interesting... the take on the game is really focused on highlighting those elements. Okay, so let's take a look where we are. We're on the German turn now. Germans obviously aren't going to take a rest and relaxation turn. We feel an opening's been made over here. So we get either a draw, and remember, we don't have to worry about our hand limit at this moment, not until administrative. So if we're going to play a card, that gets us an extra draw early on. We could also pay friction to get additional cards. I don't think that's necessary. None of the other things that I need to do at the beginning of the turn are necessary, right? Yeah, I just get a card. So I'll take my card, and I get another staff work card, which looks exactly like the other one. Those are more common than I thought. Maybe the French wouldn't have thrown away the card that allows them to cancel a staff work. Oh, they haven't. Because those are valuable cards. Now, what can I take here? In the operations phase, I could play these suckers to remove some friction if I have it, but I don't have any. I'd get my reinforcements. Yay, here it comes. And it looks to me, I'd like to have them in Trier, but I've got a unit there. So I'll put them, same as Saarbrücken. I'll put them here in Landau. I could also get some replacement points. I don't need any, I haven't lost anything. And now I get to decide my movement. Well, I'm not gonna specify out the movements here, but my plan, and it didn't last turn either, my plan is to try to push through here and take advantage of what I see as that French weakness. But I've got some other things. I need to get control of the rail lines, and in particular that means I'm gonna not move some units in order to lay these guys under siege. This is the most important one, but I do want to take this out as well. And that cuts them off from supply. Notably, that cuts this thing off from supply. That's a problem. The French should have thought about this more carefully. That's the Imperial Guard. That's Napoleon there, Napoleon III, who's trapped now. Uh-oh. Oops. Which I forgot to check to see if Napoleon III was overthrown last turn. I'm going to just pretend that I checked and it was fine. Basically, there was a difference of 2 points in morale. So there was a one-third chance that the umpire just fell on the very first turn of the game. Nothing I can do about that. To create the German Empire, I need at least a 4-point span. And I got to keep a memory that this is the case. But I also have to be near Paris and occupying two depots other than Paris. All right. I guess I'll move on with my movement. Speed seems somewhat of the essence. I'm guessing that this is Napoleon III and not this. So I want to get into position where I've got Toul at least under some sort of siege. To do that, I'm gonna need to move 2, 4, I could actually get these guys out of there. 2, 3, 4. Let's see what kind of movement I've got here. I've got 3-point movements. I've got a few choices. I can use the Manteuffel, which, as I make up a pronunciation and say it with some authority, to use
No, that's the wrong one. I could use the, the mantiful. Take a point of friction in order to give one stack two extra movement points. But alternatively, I can play the staff work one, which allows me to pay one friction and give all my units an extra point. Now that's all I actually need here is 2-4 to get into position on that. So that's what I'm gonna do. Now, let's look at this. This negates a German staff card. So, since the cards are discarded without effect, that doesn't cost the Germans anything except the card itself. But luckily for me, I have another one, and I'm going to play that one because I think this is still... Well, see, some of the other options are kind of nice here. What about the other options on this card? I like this reaction option, but I have that with the march to the guns already. Kind of unfortunate that the march to the guns doesn't require that there be a battle undergone in that involving the zone of control that you're moving into, just because of the name of the card. Interesting looking fella. This card seems less generally useful. I kind of like the idea of holding on to a staff work card, so I'm going to actually use this one in my movement instead. And that'll give me one of these, which isn't a good thing. Friction point marker there. And allow me to move this. Now, because there's no zones of control, because of the fortresses, I can move into place, and I'll go 2-4. Keep this stacked together here. Yeah, I said I wasn't going to worry too much about it all. I wasn't going to zoom in the way I did, but I did want to do that because of the card play effect. And you got to kind of keep an eye out. Yeah, because these cards have reactive abilities, so that's why they're all face up for me. And now I'll try to figure out how to cope with these other attacks. Attacking the fortresses requires that I to use the I can't use the siege table except within an attack, from what I remember. Yeah, I think I have to actually commit to making an assault, essentially, to use the siege table. But the siege table may help me in that attack. All right, so I'll try to set up for those sieges, because I do want to take these fortresses out in my rear area at the same time that, I'm preparing for an attack here, perhaps. My situation isn't as pleasant as I had hoped. Got a fairly powerful force here, and I'm going to launch that attack. I think that's the Emperor. It's not, but over here, the problem that I have is everything that could reach was dummies, except for this unit. Do I want to launch an attack? Probably a bonus effect. Do I have any combat cards that can help me? This does against a Paris fortress. Let's say I'm on the even table. How ugly is that? Well, it's not terrible. I could cause a minor defeat with that, but I could use that card here. 9. I got a pretty big bonus there. So, yeah, I may use this sucker to give me the bonus there. This doesn't give me any morale penalty, because it's not against Paris, so that's appealing. March to the guns. I can ignore enemy zones of control for combat obligations. Well, I don't have any obligations, so I'm not going to use that for this. So I'm going to declare attacks in all places. These guys are not attacking. They don't have to. There's no zone here. Which one do I want to do first? Well, I want to do this one first, and we have no hidden units here. do I want to use the siege table here? Let's take a look at this. I got the sortie problem, which looks like a weakness to me. Let me look up fortresses, because see, the losses here, I'm going to need at least a minor defense. Now, I've got a huge advantage here, which means on a 3 or higher, I succeed. I may not want... I think I do. I'm going to roll on the siege table. A 1 is my only bad roll, and that's less likely than getting a 1 or a 2 here. And I've got some things that could just eliminate the fortress all at once. I get a 6 honors of war. The fortress is eliminated. I do not get any morale out of this. Pity. So that is the end of this fortress. And it's bagged effectively. I don't get to advance, however. Which is a shame. I would have liked the extra movement capability there. All right, let's go to the next one. Do I want to use the siege table here? And the answer is most definitely. I do get to look at what I'm facing, and I'm at even odds here with the Emperor. We can play cards on siege. I don't have any. I do have one. But this is in the battle card, not the siege card. I wish it were the siege card. Yeah. I roll a 6. It's again honors of war. The mobile units go to the nearest friendly city hex, not in an enemy zone of control. Now that's this and this. This is not in an enemy zone of control, but I'm going to pull back to there. Again, the fortress falls. And we're getting decent results here. So now, I want to go for this, and I still have this card if I need it. We have a dummy which goes away. When they're revealed, they go away. And now we have a 9-2, which is going to be this big chart. I'm going to again roll on the siege table. I think it's to my advantage. And we get another honors of war. Trust me, the dice ain't loaded. All right. So now we go to administrative, and I get a card to draw, which I'd like to. I don't have my full hand here. Or I can remove half my friction, or I can pass. Now, this is the only way that I have to remove friction, other than by taking rest and relaxation. Whereas on my operation phase, I'm going to get that free card anyway. Of course, that costs me a card. I'm going to remove the friction point. I'm not sure which makes more sense, but I like that idea. We haven't taken anything still. Hand doesn't discard, and I get to reconceal my units and spawn a dummy. I gotta remember, flip them this way. And I will take the dummy up at the front here. Dummies are almost real units. I could have launched a siege here. Not attacked, but I could have besieged the city with dummies. That's kind of a weird thought, right? But they're not exposed by that action. All right, let me take a little break because my camera's running low. I make the same mistake, actually. I've got a 1-point morale difference here. I got to check to see if the Empire falls. Nope, still rolling sixes and nothing but. That's going to be an interesting game if that's all I can roll. Pretty bad for the French, I would assume. We don't have a lot of defensive capability. I'm going to peek at these
A lot of strength the Germans attacked me with here. You wouldn't be able to do this ordinarily, but I take breaks, so hidden movement games, I try to remind myself at least which pieces I should be aware of, try to remember that kind of stuff when I come back. Okay. So, the big question with the French is, do they want to take another R&R turn? That's kind of one of the issues that I'm beginning to see with this. There doesn't look like a whole lot of opportunity for the French to launch attacks. They could, of course, do so. I have a significant little force. I could throw the guard in and maybe slam this poor sucker out of supply. If I have some combat cards, that would be appealing. But I do not. Let me see what my strength is going to be here, because I may have opened things up. That's 8 strength points, hitting 9. I don't want to make low odds attacks. This table does not look at all pleasant, even, you know, with this, if I don't have the cards to back it up. So, another R&R turn it is. And what I was saying is, I kind of get lost in my thoughts when I'm chattering, is that these rest and reorganizations may be too appealing for the French, where they're not going to really want to do a lot of attacks. They're going to want to be constantly falling back. So, let us... All right, so we look at the organization phase. We don't draw cards. We can discard our hand cards and draw up to full. Now, I like the cards I have, so I'm just going to draw an additional card there. That's not too bad. And I also get an immediate morale point, which helps boost the Empire a little bit. And then I can remove half my friction points. I don't have any. So now I go to mobilization, and I have a reinforcement coming in. And again, I can't move to the front. That's the problem here. And now I can pay to get the guard a mobile, which I think I'm going to do. You might ask, well, why are you doing this? Well, you know, you didn't take the other unit that you can take, the Africa unit, and you're still not taking it. Yeah, but this one is holding up a card in my hand. So I'm going to throw these into place here. Do I get anything else in mobilization? It doesn't look like it. So now I'm on movement. And I need to build up a defense against this push forward here. That's going to be tough to do, because I don't have a lot of movement capability here. But I don't really, unless I launched an attack, have it there. Available. And there's just not a lot I can do here. I'm having trouble getting away from this German advance. Okay. Which allows the Germans now to play reaction cards. I can use any card for a reaction. It's only a 1 hex gain. Now, that, and it's on a per unit basis unless I use this one, which could allow me to march up to here. No, there's no zone there, sorry. I could try to force these guys to attack. That sounds like an appealing proposition. I think I'm going to use that. So I'm going to discard this to move my stack. The hex is the enter R in an enemy. So I'm going to march to here. And that's going to force the French to make an attack here. Well, the French don't have to make an attack. They get, because they're doing this reaction move, and I'm still in supply here. Because they, I believe, oh, let me make sure of that. See, my worry here is, I don't know if I can draw supply from here because I don't have the city of Metz. I was explaining the rules. I kind of explained it as the Germans wouldn't be able to trace from this. Now, if I go to here, I would be able to, but this is a less valuable thing because I wouldn't be gaining ground. Here I'm sort of gaining some ground. If I couldn't trace to this space, I would have to trace back to here. And I had made some claim about you have to hold the connection. That's for full rail movement. You have to control that, I guess. When I look up the supply rules, which geez, I just did, but this book doesn't stay open. It's rule 13. I can't work on the number there because obviously it's not the page number. It's the page number for some other thing. The railroad supply path looks like it can just trace through rail supplies through friendly or enemy territory back to a depot that's functioning well. That is successful here. So I'm going to indeed spend that card, the march to the guns, to get up there and force the French to engage. Now, because they're doing a rest and relaxation, they're not actually forced, or reorganization, they're not actually forced to attack. They're going to conduct disengagement battles, applying an automatic attacker withdrawal effect. Attacker withdraw is all units must retreat a hex, and then I'd be allowed to advance. Now, that retreat can't be into a zone of control, so this is going to be my closest retreat space. Do I want to advance into that hex? No, and I'm not going to pay a friction point to do so. So we go back here. And now we're on our administrative phase. We can draw another card. Since we've lost one, that might be worthwhile. Or we can remove friction. I'm going to draw a card. I think. Chanzi. Recalled from Algeria to command the units in the Army of the Loire. So he gives me a good mobilization pick, combat, 2 strength points, attacking or defending. I can also discard it as a reaction, in which, in addition to the normal reaction, I also cause a point of friction on the Germans. Just kind of neat. And now I'm allowed to reconceal my units and drop a dummy somewhere. Well, there's only one place I can put a dummy. I'll put it here in Dijon. And that is it for this turn. And that pushes me to the September turn. I've been marking who goes next by putting the dice on that side of the table, but the turn marker gives you that ability too. It's a flipped turn marker. I always like those. All right. Back on the French, can we do something other than arrest and reorganization? Is there something of value that I can do? Actually, that was the French turn. Alright. So we should be on the Germans. I just left the dice here and managed to confuse myself somehow. Because I remember the French had to withdraw with their arrest and relaxation. So, what do we move forward with? Obviously, we're not doing an R&R. So we have a choice of a card or getting rid of friction point. We don't have a friction point, so we pull a quick card. Counter battery fire. We get a plus one strength point to every supplied infantry unit in a single battle. That's kind of nice. All right, now we have to decide where our attack is going to focus. Now remember, movement
isn't terribly fast in this game. I can't make big leaps. I think I want to center my attack on Verdun, which is not a normal fortress. This is one you get to choose where to put at the beginning setup. And given the positioning of the fortresses that are fixed in the game, it seemed like a good place to put it. However, now I'm seeing a big opening down here, huh? Alright. Well, let me get the German mobilization. We don't have any reinforcements coming in. We don't have anything we can replace. So we go to the movement and I'll start doing that on. And again, we're in a position where we're attacking the French. The French up here at Verdun, I was able to slide those advanced units into place to get a big attack in place. Now, the French have their reaction move, and they may not want to lose this unit. Remember, that causes them something. Not good at remembering rules, we know that. That causes 2 morale loss and 1 addition for the Germans. See, now here it's strange. What they say is when it goes, this is why I misinterpreted this perhaps. The rules state that when it goes, he goes, along with the French Second Empire government, which leads me to believe that would be an effect for this, but it doesn't seem to change the creation of the Third Republic. And if we look at the politics rules, you check during your mobilization phase, but here it says it's checked during the Germans' administrative phase. The cards and the rules are not in alignment here at all. Now, this one probably is mobilization. It doesn't say otherwise. And there doesn't seem to be any penalty. Well, as an immediate effect, so you gain a die roll of morale, you reshuffle the deck, get more cards, but you must R&R. So I don't know. Overall, it's not really to Germany's advantage to overthrow that, and it doesn't seem to have any effect on the Imperial Guard counter, which it says its loss is a game changer. Okay, the morale changes are in effect, but here's the thing: it doesn't say anything about the French Second Empire. You know how to get rid of the Second Empire from that. Nor, if the Second Empire is already stopped, does it seem to remove this in any sense? That's nor this effect. So Napoleon III would still be some sort of figurehead, I guess. All right. I don't want to lose that unit. I think losing that unit is worse than losing Verdun, to tell you the truth. So I would like to do a reaction phase. I'm allowed to spend a card. I don't have any special ones. But this is kind of interesting. I can change any withdraw to an indecisive result. Well, that effectively happens in a fortress anyway. I can add 2 strength points to this. I think I'm actually going to hold on to, I'm going to try to hold this location, which means we declare the attack and we're not going to declare this unit. It's not in a zone of control, so we don't have to. And it's a dummy, so we don't want to. So we have some 13 strength points. This is the majority of the German army facing 4. That's terrible odds.
However, the defender could use friction to reduce the attacker's strength. I don't have that. Terrain. Let me see if that city did anything. We missed one before. Yeah, the city adds another point. I don't think that had any effect on my prior attacks. So let's do the siege roll, because I've already figured out, even at the highest level, that siege roll is worth taking. 4, it's a reduction. The fortress is eliminated or reduced if it has a reduction unit. This one does not have a reduction unit. Can't do a siege roll. I'm not already besieging it. Never mind. All right, but we do want to launch our attack. Oh, I hope I didn't do siege rolls on those other cities early. All right, so the attacker has the potential to play a combat card. I've got some 13 points. I could gain to get 2 die rolls. That's pretty good. That's probably my best way forward here, so I'm gonna do that. And the French have one as well. They're gonna play the Magnificent Positions, which, well, see, that gives you 2 strength points. That's not gonna help, because I'm at 13 to 4. It's gonna give me a 9, and 2 strength points isn't gonna reduce that to 6. So I leave it alone, because none of my combat results are gonna help. None of my combat cards are gonna help me here. All right. So we go to the attack. And I get to roll both dice. I get a 5, which is a total destruction. Everything's eliminated. And that is a French unit. 2 French units are eliminated. And the Germans get 2 morale for taking that. And we just took out the big unit. This is... I don't remember who gets the 2 and who gets the 1. Yep, the French lose 2. The Germans gain 1. The morale span's big. We're going to see the Empire fall here, I believe. And what else? The victor is allowed to advance after combat for free. I'm going to just advance this unit. Notice the circle here. These guys double in as your control markers as well. And now... Now... Well, we push this forward. And we're in the administrative phase. Do I want to draw a card or lose my friction point? Remember, that friction point can be used to hit me for a point of damage or a number of other things, slow my movement. However, it requires a die roll here. So what can I do? I can force him to show me my hand. That's kind of nice. I can reduce movement for a single stack. I can reduce the combat strength by 1. I can force a reroll. Stop opponent's card draw. Stop concealment of units and unit spawn. That's the dummy unit spawn. And I could spawn an additional movement unit by spending... spawn another dummy unit by spending my opponent's friction points. Which is more painful? I don't rightly know, to tell you the truth. I'm only going to get 1 card here. And these cards tend to be pretty valuable. On the other hand, I don't like friction points. They give the opponent advantages. So, you know, I mean, causing a 1-point change in a battle is something
that many of the cards allow. So I'm going to discard one of them. I can always R&R and fill out my hand. Of course, that slows down my advance. So, what do? We pulled that off. And now we check. We're not sitting on any objectives. There really aren't any except Paris, I think. The depots kind of cause value, though, as does being adjacent to Paris. All right. And over here, see any morale changes there, but here this is going to be automatic switch to the Second Empire, to the Third Republic, because I am going to automatically roll less than or equal to the difference. So this flips over and the French immediately gain some morale. 5 points puts me up to a 9. Reshuffle the deck, draw, and I'm forced to take an R&R turn. My hand size is bigger, and I'm going to get some additional reinforcements here. That's this pile. Now, these come in differently. National Guard comes in, I believe, immediately. Let's see where they tell us. Okay, we have to see the exclusive rules. They didn't give us a rule number there, but there aren't too many, so that's not too bad. It's right here. It's placed in Paris. If it's a French-controlled hex, it can trace a supply line, and it would not cause overstacking. If that's not possible, it goes to the closest French-controlled supplied hex that would not be overstacked. My choice. I'll put it here. Paris isn't really in danger here. The other units, I roll a die for to see how many turns in advance they're going to show up. So first the Loire. Actually, this is going to happen during the reinforcement phase, I guess. I don't know. It's not really clear. I rolled a 3. 1, 2, 3. Maybe it's not. And then the other one, I rolled an unknown, very high number. 6, 3, 4, 5, 6. A long ways away. All right. Now, I get to reshuffle the cards, draw a couple extra cards, and then I'm forced to take the R&R. Well, I got a couple of cards here. One is Garibaldi. It'll give a mobilization. Removing the card from play. Giving a friction point and 2 morale. Or a friction point and only 1 morale and the Vosges unit. Also removing it from play. If it's Second Empire holding this card becomes just kind of a waste during that period. But you could, of course, hold on to it because it has some bonuses for morale. And you can see the French have a lot of morale now that the Republic's in play. Might be possible to drive the French down to defeat without replacing Napoleon, which, if you don't hit him, it could have some advantages. Balance of power, though, this is an event card, which means it gets played immediately. The side with less morale gets 2 if the French government is Second Empire. So, or 1 if it's Third Republic. So we get another French morale. And then France loses a morale if the Army of Africa entered play. It hasn't yet. Or 2 if it's been eliminated. So that doesn't come into effect. Then both sides are going to reshuffle their deck and discard piles to form new draw piles. Afterwards, remove this card from play. I would suggest removing this card from play before you shuffle it back into the deck. Just for ease. But now I get to reshuffle the German. Now, I don't remember if events mean that I get to... See, like with Null Retreat, which this game kind of reminds me of, the way it uses the cards, etc. And I assume the 20s, the Napoleonic 20s also feel kind of like this. Like with that game... you're constantly having to look up little things because there's so much having to do with stuff you're not familiar with in a war game. The management of cards and stuff like that. Now, what was I supposed to remember there? Whether or not I get a draw from the event pile. Because the event feels like I kind of lost a card, right? And let's see if there's any rule on the cards. There probably is. Operations cards. I don't see an event card specific rule. Now this is page 3, but it's not, so we'll go to try to find rule 7 in here. And it's not, even though it's organized in a normal way, it's not the easiest book to maneuver from, part because of the physical construction. From what I can tell, it doesn't look like you get a replacement when you end up... you also get a reshuffle if your draw pile is empty. It doesn't look like you get any replacement if you end up with an event card. You just get screwed by that event. So, we'll shuffle the Germans, and then we'll go to the French. What about these card decks? I recently played Cruel Necessity, and I had some complaints about the shuffling ability for the cards. These look like about the same size deck. They may be a tiny bit bigger, but not much. They shuffle much, much more easily. So I don't know, the component quality or whatever seems pretty good for them. And they seem very easy for shuffling. That's always a factor for me. I really despise playing where I don't feel like I can shuffle the cards safely. You know, when I play something like Talisman with all its sharp corners and the cards are different textures because they're from different expansions, that really irritates me, and some of them don't shuffle well at all, especially my homemade ones. But these seem to work quite well. And I'll try to remember that when I do my review. Where are we? We're on a rest and relaxation or whatever. We'll look for that green section that I remember it by. So the color's actually helping me here a little bit. Okay, and first I don't draw my cards. I'm allowed to discard anything I don't like and then draw up to my limit. I think if I don't discard, I'm allowed to hold on. Yeah, well, I've got 4 cards. If I had an extra card, I think I'd be allowed to hold on to it at that point. So, what do I feel? I still like this card. I definitely like this card. This one, I'm not so impressed with this. Furia Francesa. Napoleonic Tactics. That doesn't sound very good. The Garibaldi card. How cool is that? I like it because it gives me a unit. So I'm going to hold on to that. But I am going to throw this one away and take a new card. We had this already. We are hunting Franck's Tyrias down pitilessly. Good. So, I'm going to need to plug in, unfortunately. I'm still having to... Feeling like I have to go through the rules constantly, so that actually makes me vid longer, because I feel like if I'm still exploring the game, you probably are too. I can't just step away the way I like to. Do not draw cards in the normal manner. Receive a morale point. Yeah. There's one. Remove half my friction points. Yeah. Hard to grab. All right, now I go to mobilization, and I like my mobilization here. So first thing is, let's see, I have three, four, I only have four replacement points left, so I still can't buy this big unit. I may want to break down a unit if I had anything reasonable size to get my little detachments, even though they're not very good, they allow me to cover more terrain. I want to play the Garibaldi card. That costs me one friction. I just got rid of a friction. I gain a morale. I get the Vosges unit. And does it say where Dijon or Belfort? I can't play it because, geez, this is overstacked anyhow. Now, by the rules of the game, I lose one of those units. Did I have to? I believe so. I don't know what the hell. I think I was forced into this position. What do I want to lose? I hope I have a... Yes, these counters do not handle well. I don't want to lose a real unit. I think this fort is impossible, so I'm going to get rid of the fort, unfortunately. I think I was forced to retreat into that space and then just didn't notice it. Okay. So, and anyway, you know, there's the no take back, so if you do screw up, you're screwed. Yes, I can take the reinforcement. That doesn't hurt me. So I already took that. I already took the morale bonus. I get to take this. I'll put it in Dijon. I got to remember to move it, though. And this card is going to be removed from the game. I don't have any other things I want to mobilize. Now, I could have lost not the fort and mobilized other units, but that's okay. Now I'm somewhere, I'm in the movement phase, and I've got I'm going to do at least one rail move. Up to here. I can do this because I'm moving closer to this along it, and then maybe Paris, and then I continue moving closer to Paris. But my other units have to move normally. And I'm going to try to throw some kind of ring of defense around Paris. Continuing my withdrawal, these guys are worth victory points at the end of the game, but that's not a big deal to me. What I do want to avoid, though, is losing points for not having depots. In this particular depot, I've left a unit back because that'll discourage the Germans from moving closer. Now, it's not much of a unit. It's just a dummy. You're a dummy. Yeah, I know. Okay, there's not going to be any combat, so we go to administrative and nothing changes there. I wish almost that there was an R&R phase summary on here. I'm looking at that page the most in the rules. For whatever value that is. So now I get to either draw a card, and I've got room for that extra card, or lose one of these. Now again, if we look at what we can do with them, and this, you know, is just part of the game, having to look up all this stuff until you're really, really familiar. So this says the attacker must reroll the battle die. Yeah, both people can spend friction to do that. I wanted to make sure I understood that. I think I'd rather have a card for the French, and I get the Mr. Toad's Wild Ride again. And that ends... I had a reinforcement, son of a bitch, that I forgot to put in play. I could have brought that in here in Paris and moved it here. I get to spawn one of these, I believe, as well. And I don't know where to put it. I'll dump it there for more flexibility. And what else? having to follow a sequence this carefully, because the game has some significant differences from what I expect of a normal game, it's just not sinking in as well as a lot do. And, you know, once you get more familiar with the system, I'm sure it becomes easier. But again, when you diverge too much, as this does, as No Retreat does, from how, you know, the classic game works, the harder it is to kind of actually get into the game and be doing more than following this procedural list of what you have to do. So I think I'm at the end of the turn there, and I keep forgetting to move this. This moves forward. Put the dice up here now, since I don't need to do that. I don't need to keep track with the board. And we'll send this one up. Slow going, it's been to get through what really is probably a fast-playing game otherwise.